overwhelmed. So what's the potential problem here? Some puppies find going outside those first couple of times really scary. And as an owner, it can be very difficult to prevent that from happening or to manage that properly those first couple of times before it actually escalates into some sort of anxiety. Well, the world is a big and scary place for a very young little puppy. Sometimes they don't feel like they're given much support on those first couple of walks. We're so excited to get them outside that we forget how scary a bus can be or a bike can be. Also, puppies don't seem to have very many options, do they, when they're out and about? I mean, let's face it, they're either on a lead or they're in our arms. So where can a puppy go if they suddenly feel frightened by it and just want a bit of space or a bit of time to process? There's nowhere they can go. There's nowhere of the puppy explaining to us appropriately, "Hi, can I go home now? This is a bit much for me." Instead, what we tend to do is we tend to kind of waterlog them with lots of people, lots of new experiences, all in one go. For some really confident puppies, that's fine. They take it all in their stride, they go home, they sleep, they think about it, and they go, "Okay, that was nice." For some puppies, this can be really, really daunting. For all puppies, doing a bit of socialisation before they're ready to go out for their first walk is a really brilliant idea. It gets the puppy used to the different stimulus that's going to be outside and that's going to be exciting or frightening in a way that's positive and in a way where they can opt out and walk away should they want to. In addition to that, we're also going to go through a little bit of greeting behaviour. So teaching puppies to sit when they're being greeted by people is a really brilliant thing because we can practice it indoors and then we can also practice it outside, and it stops puppies from jumping up, particularly bigger puppies. Tend to jump up to new people when they're very excited. It's very hard to teach new people, "Can you not reward my puppy for jumping up and not fuss them?" Because they're a puppy and all they want to do is squish it and cuddle it and kiss it in the face. So instead, by teaching our puppies that default behaviour of, "New person, I want to cuddle, sit," then we're much more likely to be able to practice that desirable behaviour and for the puppy to succeed.
So the game we're going to play with the dog is very simple. The rules are that when someone new comes in, or you can play this just with your family if he's still jumping up at your family, as soon as he sits, he gets a treat as well as attention. All the time that he's in the sit, the visitors are allowed to stroke him. As soon as he breaks the sit, the visitors stop stroking him and take a step back, ask him to go into the sit again. And then all the time that he's in the sit, he gets the attention. So we're teaching dogs that if they want fuss, they stay in the sit. And then they get fuss, and they also get treats. If your dog decides to come away, that's fine too. Don't call them back. Allow them to leave the visitors and choose to walk back in. If they want to walk back in, they'll reapproach you and go into the sit. Again, all the time that they're in the sit and they're choosing to play the game, they get fuss and attention and treats. And then any time they no longer want to play, they can just get up and walk away. Or simply get up to say, "Actually, I've had enough now of this new person and I don't want to play your silly games anymore." It's completely up to the dog whether or not they approach the visitor and sit or choose to leave them alone.
Going to do is, if your puppy seems quite confident, you're going to take them outside, just outside the house with the door kept open so that the puppy can choose to go back in should they want to. And if you're going to use a clicker, you can use a clicker here, or if you're not, then you can mark it with a word like "good" or "well done." Now, every time something happens that could be potentially scary or potentially exciting, so a person walking past, a bike walking past, a dog walking past, a bus going past, a car, all those things, we're going to click or say "yes, good boy," "good girl," and give them a treat. So they're going to say, "New thing, scary, food, brilliant." So we're going to counter condition all these things right from the word go. After the puppy gets used to the general things, you can wait it out and not give them treats and only give them treats when things that seem really frightening or really exciting happen. We're teaching the puppy to come to you for rewards when these exciting or frightening things are happening. Now, if your puppy at any point shows body languages that might seem a bit frightened, so licking lips, or looking away from something, or kind of blinking, or backing off at all, then what we're going to do is we're going to take them inside the house, so further away from those things that are frightening, and carry on playing that game. If a puppy seems really frightened, what's a good idea is taking the lead off putting a baby gate or something in front of the front door, having the door open, sitting by the front door, and just rewarding the puppy for coming and having a look. All we're doing here is teaching our puppies to process all this stuff that's going to come and happen and go past outside in that big outside world before we actually take them out for those first walks. By doing this, we can make those first walks a much more positive, exciting thing, because they've already got used to the scary things. We're breaking it down, and there's no reason why not to do it, really. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that you found it useful and that we've answered most of the questions that you've got, and book yourself onto a good puppy class. We use the Gwen Bailey Puppy School scheme and operate in Eastbourne and in Brighton, but we also provide other puppy training in Bexhill areas and also Worthing. There are lots of trainers out there. Make sure that you find one that you feel makes sense and that you feel provides your puppy with a really good, positive, well-organised experience of life out and about. Never feel bad about leaving a class if you feel uncomfortable or if you feel like your puppy is frightened or not learning what you want them to learn in those classes. We're a part of the Institute of Modern Dog Trainers, the IMDT, so it's worth checking out their website and seeing if there's a good IMDT trainer near you that does puppy classes. If you have any questions or any comments or any feedback, we'd love to hear from you. Have a look on the website, www.school4dogs.com. There's a contact us form on there, so use that and let us know any feedback or anything like that. Okay, thanks very much. Enjoy your puppy.